Photosynthesis is arguably the most important biological process there has ever been. Aside from simply creating the climatic conditions that made multicellular life possible, photosynthesizing organisms continue to graciously provide our planet with the oxygen that basically everything needs to live. And yet, scientists are looking for ways to make photosynthesis even better. And if they crack it, we could use photosynthesis to power stuff like cars. You might remember the equation for photosynthesis from your freshman biology class. The process is relatively simple. Basically, plants take in sunlight, water, and carbon dioxide and turn that into oxygen and stored energy in the form of glucose. And while it's the foundation for virtually all life on Earth, photosynthesis is surprisingly inefficient. Plants are only able to store about 1% of all the energy they receive from the sun. But researchers know they can do better than that. So for decades, they've been trying to create artificial forms of photosynthesis in order to power our whole world. Now you might be thinking, but isn't that just a solar panel? Well, yes, and also no. Solar panels soak up the sun's rays to generate electricity, which is an immediate energy source resulting from the flow of charged particles. But photosynthesis makes something that stores energy. So think the difference between electricity and something like gasoline. Gasoline stores energy within its chemical bonds and then releases that energy when it gets ignited, and takes up very little space to do so. And while generating solar electricity is able to power our homes and cars, it can't always substitute for combustible fuels, which provide an unbeatable combination of power and compactness. Roughly 40% of global transportation is incapable of being electrified. I mean, you'd need a pretty big battery to get a Boeing 747 off the ground. So while solar panels generate electricity, the goal of artificial photosynthesis is to use solar energy to produce usable fuel, which is done by splitting apart water molecules just like plants do. This basic design for artificial photosynthesis has existed since 1998, and even back then it was way more efficient than nature's version. However, in basically all the designs we've ever had for the process, it can either be durable, efficient, or cheap, but never all three at once, which is a big part of why we haven't been using artificial photosynthesis much so far. But if we do manage to make the process cheap and efficient, what could it be used for? Well, one type of fuel that researchers want to make is hydrogen, which burns cleanly, is zero carbon, and could be used to power future combustion engines or fuel cells. However, hydrogen gas is pretty scarce and is still mostly derived from fossil fuels. But we can make hydrogen fuel using a system called an artificial leaf. These pseudo-leaves utilize a design that features two electrodes immersed in a water-based solution called an electrolyte. The electrodes each gather energy from sunlight and use that energy to split the water into hydrogen and oxygen. This is a tricky process, not only generating the gases, but keeping them separate from each other. Hydrogen gas is very flammable and can full-on explode in the presence of oxygen. But the biggest problem often involves that liquid electrolyte we discussed earlier. That's because water has a tendency to corrode the electrodes. And as you might imagine, that's not great for the performance of electrodes. Most devices that use these liquid electrolytes could only function for less than a day before their electrodes would be completely corroded and need replacement. But in 2018, researchers at the Joint Center for Artificial Photosynthesis in California made a major breakthrough for keeping their equipment in tip-top shape. Very basically, they used a solid electrolyte instead of the usual liquid kind, and only fed water vapor into the system. Without the liquid electrolyte, the risk of corrosion went way down. Doing so minimized moisture exposure while still allowing sunlight to be harvested, making the resulting system capable of 100 continuous hours of hydrogen production. But hydrogen and oxygen aren't the only things we can make with artificial photosynthesis. Researchers can also make methane. Methane is the primary component in natural gas and the same greenhouse vapor that gives cows a bad reputation. Methane is a pretty potent greenhouse gas, but it also has major potential as an energy-dense fuel source. And instead of harvesting this methane from bovine burps, we could be making it from carbon dioxide, water, and sunlight. While natural photosynthesis results in molecules called carbohydrates, methane is a hydrocarbon, which is a whole different kind of molecule. And making it involves a major, difficult re-engineering of nature's formula. But in late 2022, researchers at the University of Chicago announced that they had created a novel system that signals a big step towards realizing this technology on a larger scale. Their design utilized what's called a metal organic framework, or MOF, which is basically a bunch of metal ions held together by organic molecules. After adding amino acids to the MOFs, the team found these compounds were really efficient at both splitting water and augmenting CO2 CO2 molecules, rearranging them into methane. And they were like 10 times more efficient than any previous model. Now, these are only a couple examples of the work currently being done to take a leaf out of Mother Nature's book. And while it might be a while before we're cooking with green methane or filling our tanks with solar fuel, artificial photosynthesis could be a key part of getting the world to become carbon neutral and slowing down the climate crisis. So thank you to all the plants out there for giving us the blueprint. Or maybe the green print? I don't know. And thank you for watching this episode of SciShow. If you liked this video, consider becoming a patron of ours at patreon.com/scishow and getting more science in your media diet. Patrons also get access to exclusive perks like our Discord community, behind-the-scenes photos and blooper reels, and our monthly SciShow podcast. So head over to patreon.com/scishow to learn more.